So once again, we're going to show you what it's like to digitize a negative image. This happens to be a Sly Stone shot we were just briefly talking about, which is about 44 years old. So what we're going to do is we take this 6x6 black and white negative, place it in the black and white negative carrier. Also, it's always dull side face up because, you know, flip it over, it's on the right side. So this is it. This is the shiny side. This is dull side, so dull side is always faced up, and goes into the scanner, which is an Epson 10000XL, which is a great scanner. It's an excellent flatbed scanner. From there, we run a preview so we can see the image. It takes several seconds to generate. You see it's going now. So this is the actual flatbed image. And there are the three slide stone images in the center. And what we do is find the shot that we want, crop in semi-tight, zoom in so I can get a tighter look at it, so I can get a better visual of where I'm cropping and make sure the image is clean and sharp. So that is the sliced image we're going to use. Crop in within the actual black and white image itself. Over here, we scale it into what we're going to do is we're going to make a high res image because most of the images that we use are print worthy, usually high res, which is about 300 DPIs at about 10 by 10 inches or 8 by 11 inches. So in this case, this would be about 10 by 10, which would be about 500% of the actual black and white image. So we change that to 500, use a very high sharp, unsharp masking system, which will sharpen the image. We don't need any black lips or any corrections, no dust removals, because that'll be done later. And we hit scan. So right now, the scanner is going, it's actually digitizing the image, and it's going to be fed into my computer and onto my screen. All right, so once the scan is done, we open up Photoshop, go to File, go to Open, and then I look for the most recent image that was done, image 385, there it is. We hit Open, and there it is. There is the high-res Sly Stone image that went from a 44-year-old negative to a brand new digitized image, which can now be used for printing, from magazine ads to packaging for albums or for posters. And what I do is from here is that I would just save the image, obviously, because we don't want to lose it, and save it as image 85. Hit save. Replace it, and none on the TIFF options, and there it is. So now it's been saved. I email it to the recipient, and from there it goes to the art department, and then it goes into packaging and onto the shelves.
So that was looking at the process for our black and white negatives, but we also have color 2 1/4 and lots and lots and lots of slides. This selection of slides is from Sly's wedding, when he got married on stage at Madison Square Garden in 1974. So I'm sure that you've scanned those many times, Che. But that's a pretty good selection of our Sly Stone stuff. Again, he's the artist of the month for March of 2013, so we're going to be celebrating him all month long. Thanks, Jay.
Thank you.
All right.
As I can be of help.
Cool. We'll see you next time on legacyrecordings.com. Again, I'm Tom Tierney here in the Sony Music Archives. Thanks.